Welcome to Nasdaq Trade Talks. I'm Jill Malandrino, Global Markets Reporter at Nasdaq. Joining me is Ed Coughlin, Director of Trader Services at Nasdaq, to recap what was a record-breaking Russell Reconstitution back in June. Ed, it's great to see you as always. Welcome back to Trade Talks.
Oh, thanks, Jill. It's always good to be here. And, especially, sitting here on a hot day and thinking back about the trade that happened last month with the Russell rebalance. I think, all parties involved, viewed it as a very, very successful event and kind of a surprise event in that, with historic volumes that took place. I mean, if you look at the volume in 2020, where we did, 1.57 billion shares, while, there was expectations that, we could beat that in terms of the volume numbers, we ended up trading 2.37 billion shares, which was, it was just, kind of amazing that I think it was both unexpected to be that large, but also it was reassuring that kind of the market took it in stride, in that their liquidity providers were, readily available, to handle the demand. I think, passive investors, are in good hands with market structure where it sits. I mean, if you look at kind of from a high level, you're looking at, $80 billion of notional value traded on NASDAQ, in that last trade of the day. And just to give you kind of some highlights, I mean, if you look at, the largest cross itself in an individual name was 40 million shares, which is enormous unto itself. And there were numerous crosses in the 5 million, plus range. And if you look at the average cross, was 600,000 shares. When you look at those types of volumes, it was, very good for the industry to have, confidence and faith in the process. And, I always measure it. Did I get any phone calls? Were there any bad trades? And there are, it's when my phone doesn't ring, it means everything is working really well.
And it all took place within 2 seconds, I believe, right?
Yeah, I think to be exact, I think it was 1.9 seconds. So when you think of technology and the advancements there to allow us to, if you can imagine what's happening there, I mean, the machine is calculating the cross, it's reporting the cross to the tape. It's reporting the trades back to the SIP for public dissemination. It's reporting to market data feeds. It's giving reports to customers who then flow downstream to the customers. And you blink your eye and next thing you know, 2.37 billion shares have traded. So pretty darn amazing. I always think back and, we want to really appreciate the technology folks that really make this happen. I mean, the process itself, there's buyers, there's a buyer and a seller and they meet and they come up with a price. If you go back 10 years ago and you imagine that we were going to trade in 2021, 2.37 billion shares with, just in a blink of an eye, I'm not sure how many people forecast that. So, we always deserve, a good shout out into the technology people that kind of make this happen. And then, secondarily to that, and I shouldn't even secondary, primarily to that is the liquidity providers that are there to step up. They're ready. Whether the crosses, were bigger than normal, they, from a pricing perspective and to ensure that, all the crosses went off at great prices, they deserve a really good shout out.
And Ed, to wrap up here in the final minute, we know the Russell Reconstitution takes place as of now, one day a year, but what does this mean for broader market structure, whether it's the opening or closing auction in general?
Well, as you know, and we've talked about in the past, we've improved the opening auction and the transparency and the flexibility to participate. We want kind of the, all of the market, to have confidence that, when they send orders to the NASDAQ, they're handled with care. And they're handled efficiently with the best price discovery process we think is out there. The growth of passive investing. When you look at trades, whether it be the Russell or the Quad Witches, or there's rebalances with MSCI, that the marketplace can have confidence that, in exposing their orders and needing liquidity, that there are liquidity providers that step up. I never want to take liquidity providers or technology for granted, but demonstrating, what is possible, and here we look at trades that are outside the realm of what people thought were possible not too many years ago. There's a really good bright future, that demonstrates the capabilities of NASDAQ. And I can tell you and reassure you that there is no process at NASDAQ that is taken more seriously. There's a lot of time, money and effort that's invested in the resiliency of the cross and to ensure that, you know, we have, you know, best practices in place. You know, when we increase the transparency and the flexibility to participate in the cross by giving people more time to see the information and the imbalance messages, the ability to interact with those orders later in the day has been really, really successful and widely accepted across the street. And I think, you know, the Russell rebalance is just another indication of the confidence people have, you know, in, you know, trading their stocks on the NASDAQ exchange.
All right, Ed, appreciate the insight as always. Thanks for joining us on Trade Talks. I'm Jill Malandrino, Global Markets Reporter at NASDAQ.